Hello and welcome everybody. Welcome to Emilia Romagna. I am Filiberto Massanti, the General Director of Consorzio Vini di Romagna, the association that for the agricultural ministry manage promoting and saving the appellation, so designation and indication of origin of Romagna, that is the eastern part of Emilia-Romagna. Our consortium is almost 60 years old and present 115 companies staying from cooperatives, wineries, aiutami Marina, private,
Privately owned estates.
and private, okay, and private wineries. We haven't managed a good number of denomination of origin, and today we are in view to taste one of the best and the most developed of our that is Sangiovese, Romagna Sangiovese. And together with Sangiovese, we are to taste any other wine of the other the denomination. So, Romagna is an amazing land, very available to open its door to everyone that live with the wanting to see every day nature and art and historical cities. And so we have a very ancient history with a lot of experience to be done. I think in the new season that come in front of us, we safely have been will be will have the possibility to see you in person and to have your visit in Romagna. I also bring greetings from my presidents. At the moment busy and I will be able to stay only short due to a series of deadlines to be observed in my work. Thank you for your presence. I leave you to this very, very good, very, very nice tasting. And thanks for your attention and see you in Romagna next week.
Grazie Filiberto, thank you so much for your nice words. Now I think we can go on, and in the meantime, I will leave you in the hands of Daniele and I'm gonna get the light to make our faces more visible, if you don't mind. Okay? There you are.
Okay. Thank you for coming. I'm Daniele Cernilli. I'm a wine journalist. I have to explain something about the wines of Romagna. But let me start with some historical information, because probably you know that there is a big region in the northern part of Italy. It's in fact a hinge between the north and the central part, the peninsular part of Italy. And Emilia-Romagna is one region, but is divided in two parts. There is the Emilia on the west, and there is the Romagna on the southeast part of the region. And for history and for the wines too, they are very different. We have some map, of course, and I have to ask to show you the first map that show you the position of Emilia-Romagna. And so you can see easily that there is a red line that divides the northern part, that is a flat land, is the valley of the Po River, with the southern part of the two sub-regions, that is hilly, and on the south there is there are the mountains, the Apennini mountains, that divides the Emilia-Romagna from Tuscany and from the Marche, so from the central and peninsular part of Italy. It's like a hinge, in fact, the Emilia-Romagna, is from the central to the north of Italy, and Romagna is the south eastern part. The history show us that the two regions are very well divided, because all the western part, the Emilia part, was under several kingdoms in the Renaissance and in the medieval times, and Romagna was under the kingdom of the Pope from the 16th to 19th century, so very different from the other part of Emilia. And the wines too, because Emilia, in fact, is the great land of Lambrusco, especially. In Romagna, they grow different varieties and they make different wines. The Sangiovese, first of all, that is the most important red varieties in the region. Then the Trebbiano, that is a particular clone of Trebbiano. They call it the Trebbiano della Fiamma, that is the Trebbiano of the Flame. Because probably the color of the Trebbiano when mature, it's very close to the color of the fire. So the Trebbiano of the Flame for this reason, probably. And the third is another white variety, is the Albana, that is a native variety of Romagna. You can find Albana only in Romagna. And so Trebbiano, Albana, and Sangiovese are the three most important varieties in Romagna. So we can start to taste the wines, of course, and I want to show you the second map, that is the map of the area of the Albana, when the Albana is grown. So. And the Albana is grown in a particular hilly sub-region called the chalk hills, because the Albana loves the chalk soil, and all the lower part of the hills of Romagna are cultivated with the Albana variety. And you know, from Sant'Arcangelo, that is in the southeastern part, to Bologna, in fact, to Ozzano Emilia, that is very close to Bologna. In this map, you can see where is Florence, for example, Firenze, that is in the lower and left part of the map. And between Florence and Bologna, and Florence and Rimini, and Forlì and Faenza, there are the Apennines and the hills, of course. So in Romagna, you have the mountains on the southern part of the region, then the hills, and then the flat land on the other part of the red line of the Via Emilia, that divides, in fact, the Romagna and the Emilia too, from the hilly part divides in two different regions, and from hilly in the south, hilly part, and the flatland on the north. So this is the area, the region of Albana, and the probably the one of the most important town for the producing of from the production of Albana is Bertinoro, that is between Forlì and Cesena, and the first hills over above Forlì and Cesena. The first wine that we have to taste is an Albana, organic Albana, by Bertinoro, and the producer of this wine is the Celli Winery, owned by Siri and Casadei family. In Bertinoro is an organic Albana. It's Albana. It's a golden white wine, because it contains a lot of phenols, and so the phenols give colors to the wine. And I don't know if you know Joe Cocker, that is a white man that sings the blues, was a white man that sang the blues. And it's similar. The Albana is a white wine that is similar to a red wine for some reasons, and the phenols that Albana contains are the similarity with the red wine. So the Albana is a white wine, but remember you some character of a red wine. Celli is an important winery in this area. They produce in organic way. The name of the wine is I Croppi, is Romagna Albana Secco, that is dry. I Croppi is a 2020, and let's taste this wine. Is the first sample you have in your selection. So the color is a golden color, evidently. The nose, remember you some exotic fruits probably, and some sense of fresh hormones, in my opinion. Some touch of flowers, in white flowers probably. And the taste is a taste of a big red white wine. Salty acidity, a good body, a good alcohol contains. So we are close to 14, a little more than 14 degrees in alcohol. So it's a very big white wine, and this is the character of the Albana. Albana is a wine like that. There is some particular Albana, the Albana Passito, that are sweet wine, and Albana in some part, if you know the international varieties, Albana is similar to a Semillon, and you know that with the Semillon, in Bordeaux they make the Sauternes, and in some part of some producer of Albana produced a sweet wine, the Albana Passito, that is a botanicalized wine like an Italian Sauterne, in if you want to make a comparison. But we have Mauro Sirri, I think, that is the representative of Celli Winery probably. And I want to invite him to tell something about the wine, about the winery, because of course he knows better than me the situation of the Albana and the winery Celli, that is an organic wine. This is a bio in Italian, an organic. Is there Mr.
Yes, I am. Hello Daniele. Hello everybody.
Okay. Hi.
Thank you Welcome. thank you for the wonderful presentation.
Thank you very much.
You are a specialist. Okay. Just to tell something more, to add something what you said before. Okay, the area, Bertinoro area, is an area where you can have two different kind of soil. The most representative soil is Spungone area, Spungone soil, limestone soil, because the area...
Limestone, but chalk too.
Chalk too, yeah. The chalk are in the hills behind Bertinoro. And there, we have some vineyards where there is the cross of limestone soil with chalk soil, and that gives to the wine a lot of minerality and also a lot of saltness test. The Albana, I can resume the characteristic of Albana in three elements. The first, as told before Daniele, the color, the gold color, of course. And Daniele told also that the Albana is quite similar to the red. We used to tell that it's the red wine dressed by white.
Yes. And, like Joe Cocker, no?
That's... Yeah, like Joe Cocker, we like very much. And also another thing, when you leave the wine in the glass, after a few minutes, the oxygen give to the wine a lighter color. It's strange. It's not usually for a white wine to have this reaction with the tannin. Second element is the acidity. The acidity is quite high. We arrive in the bottle with 14 degrees in alcohol, but in the same time we preserve 6.5 grams in acidity. And the last important characteristic of this wine is that in the hand you can have a small touch of tannin. Is the polyphenol, the richness of phenol that have this kind of grape that leave a small touch of tannin that gives a great balance to the structure of this wine.
You know, I'm Roman, and I like carbonara. That is a Roman recipe.
Yeah.
Right wine to match the carbonara.
Wonderful. Well,
Indian body, and it is important.
Yeah. When I will come again to Rome, I bring with me a bottle of Albana, and you make carbonara. Okay.
Yes, of course. I make a fantastic carbonara in my home.
So, okay. Well,
I hope to meet you as soon as possible, Mr. Siri. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Grazie.
Okay, and let's go on and let's get into the Sangiovese universe in Romagna. There is a difference between the Sangiovese in Tuscany and the Sangiovese in Romagna. The only denomination in which you can find the name Sangiovese on the label is the Romagna Sangiovese, because in Tuscany they make Brunello di Montalcino, Chianti Classico, and Vino Nobile di Montepulciano. They are made they are Sangiovese, in fact, but they have not the name Sangiovese on the label. So the real Sangiovese, officially Sangiovese, you can find on the label is Romagna Sangiovese. The history of the Sangiovese in Romagna is very important because they started in the same period of the northern part of Tuscany, between 15th and 16th century. We have some news about that. And Sangiovese is a real historical variety, probably not native variety, but historical and traditional variety. This is the area of Sangiovese. It's bigger than the area of Albana, as you can see. Because Sangiovese is possible to grow also on the higher part of the hills. There are some part of the denomination that are 500 meters above the sea level, so in altitude, the area is very important, and start from the border between Romagna and Le Marche, and reach Bologna. So we are over 60-80 miles there is a lot of possibilities of making Sangiovese in Romagna, and a lot of differences between one area and another area. So they started to make some sub-zones, sub-areas of Sangiovese. And there are, for the moment, 12 sub-areas of Sangiovese, and 4 are going to be to form, to build the 16 sub-areas in few months. So this is all the area of the Sangiovese, and there is also another denomination in Romagna that is Colli di Rimini, and in the area of Rimini will be the 4 new sub areas for making Sangiovese in the future. So we can show also the area of Rimini in it is in the south in this part, but I want to show you the map of Colli di Rimini just to remember that there is also the area, the specific area of Rimini, of course. So okay, and it's not that yes, perfect. This is the area of Colli di Rimini. You can see the area of Colli di Rimini. But we have not, Colli di Rimini is another denomination, so just to say, to show you where they are. But let's go on and take a look to the different sub-areas of Sangiovese. So the next map. And the next map shows you how many different Sangiovese is possible to make. There are different denomination in the pyramid of the quality of Sangiovese. There is the normal Sangiovese, the basic Sangiovese, then there is a Sangiovese superiore and superiore riserva, and then the sub areas that runs from San Clemente, that is very close to the border with Le Marche, and Imola, that is in the northern part of the denomination. In the middle, a lot of different sub-denomination, like the MGA in Barolo and in Barbaresco, for example, in Italy, but like the Appellation Comunale in Burgundy. There is these different expressions of Sangiovese in the different part of the territory of the region. And we start with the Sangiovese, with the first Sangiovese in our testing. And the first Sangiovese is the Morale, Romagna Sangiovese, DOC Oriolo. And Oriolo you can recognize because it's close to Faenza, the Oriolo area. And the producer is Poderi Morini. Poderi Morini, it's a fantastic estate in this part of Romagna. They produce Sangiovese, of course, 100%. This is a Sangiovese, a Romagna Sangiovese, with no wood in the aging. So the color, as you can see, is a light color for a Sangiovese. Because of that, probably it's a 2019, so it's a young Sangiovese, and 2019, yes, it's a very good vintage for this part of Italy. It's 13.5 degrees in alcohol. The nose is the classic nose of Sangiovese, so cherries, violet, it's a very varietal scent. And the acidity is more important than the tannins in this wine. And it's another character of the Sangiovese in which the prevalent, the most important organoleptic character is due to acidity, or very often less to the tannins. Saint Louis is not a Cabernet, it's not a Nebbiolo. No? And so the tannins, there are tannins, of course, but the acidity is very important and give freshness to the wine. It's a wine that you can drink easily, of course, because it's a young Sangiovese, but it's very well done, enologically speaking. I think that there is Cristiano Morini, that is the representative, one of the owner of the Poderi Morini, land of wine. It's a real land of wine, Oriolo. So, Poderi Morini, Cristiano Morini, is there Cristiano Morini?
Yeah. Good evening, everyone.
Yes, Cristiano and Alessandro Morini.
Yeah, Alessandro is my cousin, who's like sitting next to me is the
Yes, I see him.
And I take care of the exports, yeah.
Okay, so let introduce you and the Poderi Morini estate that is not very big estate, but very important for the area of Faenza and Oriolo. Huh?
Yeah, actually the winery was founded in 1998, but we've been producing grapes for about 50 years before then. So we just decided to vinify our own grapes by the end of of the 20th century. So as to reveal the ability to of the identification of our own grapes, and we have always produced wines from indigenous grapes, Sangiovese, Albana, as well as Centesimino or Loganese.
And just a question: the name of the wine is Morale, moral, ethic. I don't know. What is the reason for the name?
Well, it's also an ethic reasons, and also it's an abbreviation of Morini and Alessandro. It's
just ecco, more Ale.
Yeah.
L-L-E.
Yeah. And actually, we are located in Oriolo, these subzones, which is mainly the terroir is mainly made of clay and especially yellow sands, which gives fruitiness, but also finesse, as well as spiciness. And in this Morale 2019, which ages only in steel tanks, as you said, we have tried to reveal our terroir without being covered by wood or by long maceration, so as to reflect exactly what our terroir expresses.
It's very fresh and drinkable, in my opinion. It's a wine made to be drunk easily.
Yeah, you're right. It can be easily drunk every day, but it can also age at least a couple of years without any.
Yes, of course. But because the acidity is.
The acidity is very high.
Both acidity, so preserve the wine.
Yeah.
So, thank you very much. It's a very funny and enjoying drink, this San Romagna Sangiovese Oriolo 2019 by Poderi Morini, land of wine, Morale. Terrific. So let's go on. The third sample is the Don Pasquale. It's a lyric name. Don Pasquale is by Podere Palazzo, that is in Cesena. And Cesena, if you come back to the map, the Cesena, is in the middle of the denomination, but is in a particular part of Romagna, in the middle between Rimini and Faenza, so in the heart of Romagna. This is a Romagna Sangiovese superior, 100% Sangiovese, 250 meters on the above the sea level, and so is a bigger wine, is a 2018 or 17, is a 2000, is a 2000, excuse me, this is the other flight, is a 2018, so
18,
yes, is a 2018, and is a Sangiovese superiore from Cesena. aging is as an aging in tonneau, so a big barrique. Tonneau is a double barrique. The color is deeper and darker than the previous, of course, because of the wood probably, and because of the aging in wood and the aging at all. The nose is complex with some black cherries in the nose and some spicy scents, and the very different from the other, of course. And in the taste, you can feel more tannins, a big body. It's a very full-bodied Sangiovese, Romagna Sangiovese is a Sangiovese Superiore, so it's possible to understand that. With us, there is Sara Trevisani, that is the export manager for the USA of Podere Palazzo, and of the Don Pasquale, of course. It is the name of a lyric of an opera. So
yes, it's the name of the lyric Don Pasquale, but it's the name of very famous priest in the hill near the winery. So we name in the Don Pasquale for him, because it was he's a priest, he's a friend of the owner, and we have we love to have him with us. He's a little crazy priest in our
like it's very easy to meet some crazy priests in Romagna.
Yeah, and especially in the hill, because they are far away from the city. But it's a very unique, like our wine, I think. This was the way that we name in the wine.
Yes, but the difference between the previous wine and this is it's very deep, very huge, because this is a real big Sangiovese. It's a Sangiovese to match with some roasted meat.
Yes.
Not with the carbonara or with the matriciana. And it's a very full-bodied and intense wine, really.
We try to have the full body from a very, very picky herbalist by hand, very at the end of the summer. So we try to give him the most of the body that we can. Yeah. And the tonneau helps a lot.
Thank you very much. Okay. Please.
No, I'm okay.
Okay, thank you very much. It's a fantastic example of a full-bodied Sangiovese Superiore. And I like very much this wine, really. The tannins are so velvety, intense, warm on the palate. Very typic as a Sangiovese of this area, of Cesena area. Very interesting. Let's go on. The fourth sample. The fourth sample is another Sangiovese di Romagna Superiore, Superior Sangiovese di Romagna. Is a 2000. Is a 2018. Is a Sangiovese from San Vicinio. And the San Vicinio is in Mercato Saraceno. Mercato Saraceno is a part, an hilly part of the Romagna. And we have 240 meters on the sea level, but in the small southern area is a Sangiovese, a Romagna Sangiovese Superiore. The name is Baruccia, and the producer is Tenuta Casali, owned by Casali family, and in 2018, a lighter color in comparison with the previous, and the nose is fruity, it's the raspberry, cherries, something like that, especially, and the taste, the acidity is more evident, probably because of the area of origin of these of this wine. Age 5 months in barrique, not new barrique, not in, and second passage barrique, and it no wood in the nose and no wood tannins in the taste, in my opinion. The balance of this wine, young wine, but yet with balance and very, very drinkable wine. There is with us Silvia Casali, that is the owner, one of the owners, because the Casali family is the owner of Tenuta Casali, and Silvia Casali is there.
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Good evening, everybody.
Silvia Casali, young girl.
Not so young, but it's okay.
Because I'm old, so for me you are very young. So let introduce you and the estate. I see something like there is snow in the vineyards in the photo behind you.
10 days ago we had snow, so I make a picture.
So you are in Mercato Saraceno, San Vicinio, that is a particular part of, because it's very inside in Romagna. There is a famous church not far from you, no?
Yes, all right. So the grown vines area is located just around the Mercato Saraceno village. And we are along the Savio Valley. Savio is a river which is very important from us because he designed the fluvial terraces and on a sandstone rock. So here we have three different terraces about designed by the Savio River. So in the first, we have a medium consistency soil and we go from 120 to 160 meters on the level of the sea. In the second, we have a gravelly and stony soil mixed up with clay, and we go from 160 and 200 meter. And in the third, we have a clay soil with a big slope, and we go from the 200 to 370 meters.
370 meters is a lot. And yeah. And you are.
We just plant new vineyards up to 370 meters.
Okay, if you look at the map,
wine we are drinking right now, it's coming from the second gravelly, clay soil. So it's 100% Sangiovese. Yes. It's a single vineyard wine. So it's a Vigna Baruzza is the name of the area where my father planted the vineyard 30 years ago almost.
You called Vigna Baruzza until last year. Now is Baruzza and that's it. It's not Vigna Baruzza in the language.
It's the opposite. Until last year was Baruzza, and after that we asked for for the mentioned Vigna.
It's much better. It's much better.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now is Vigna Baruzza. It's not only.
Yeah. Now is Vigna Baruzza. Yes. Okay. San Vicinio is the Mercato Saraceno wine area, as I said before. And so this vineyard is not so far from the winery.
Okay.
What we do in the vineyards is organic agriculture. And you said something very important before, because you said that it's a lighter color Sangiovese, very fruity with good freshness. I think it's because of the characteristics that the Savio River gives to our valley. So even in the hot summers, we always have a fresh breeze coming down from the mountains. And as you can see on my back, we have mountains up to 1,000 meters. So always in the summer, we have the breeze along the Savio River going to the Cesena and then to the valley.
So you are in the middle of the mountain. You have the mountain on your on your shoulder.
Yeah, we are in the middle of the mountain, but Mercato Saraceno is in a point of the valley where it is big enough to have light and breeze.
I know very well. If you look at the map, you have these yellow roads that cut the Romagna.
It is the Sacro Valley.
If you look at the yellow road, the yellow road cross all the territory of Mercato Saraceno, and your winery is right the map. So you are in Mercato Saraceno, in the southern part of Mercato Saraceno area, so not very far from the mountain. So you are 300 meters on the sea level, but the mountain freezes the weather, and so give wind and a lot of differences between day and night during the maturing of the grapes, and this is very important to maintain the sense of the wine.
Exactly. And about minerality, I think the kind of soil, the stone, sandstone rock that we have under our soils, that gives to the wines this kind of minerality. I think we can find the minerality within our Sangiovese Reserva and our whites. It's a common number in our wines. What we do is just organic agriculture, and the fermentation is run on from indigenous yeast, because we don't want to cancel that the work that we do primary in the vineyard. And I have to say something, because sorry, maybe I send an old version of the technical sheet. We have 20 and 30 hectoliters vats for aging the wine. So they are no toast oak. So that's why the wine is still very fruity and not over oaky style, I mean. And in the last years, the production is a little bit increased, a little bit. So we decided to split from barrique to the 20 hectoliters cask.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And let's go on. And we go to Predappio. And the Predappio is on the south of Forlì. This is the area. And we have one of the star of Predappio, that is the Sangiovese Romagna Riserva Predappio di Predappio, Vigna del Generale, by Alessandro Nicolucci. So this is one of the most awarded wine in Romagna. It's a 2017. This aged 2 years in big oak casks, so big barrels, and 15 degrees. So a big wine, really. From Predappio, so 350 meters above the sea level, and the color is very deep. 2017 was a very hot vintage, and so the color is due also to that. The nose is very intense and spicy. The note of the sense of ripe fruits, red fruits, of course, berries, blackberries, especially. And a very interesting balance between the tannic part, so the phenolic part of the wine, and the acidity, because of 350 meters on the sea level, because we are in altitude. And probably there is Alessandro Nicolucci with us, and I don't know if he wants to explain us what is this superstar of the denomination, because it's very I think all the Italian guide has a good consideration of this wine. Is there Alessandro Nicolucci?
Yeah, I'm here. Yes.
So introduce you yourself and explain what is your estate and what is the Fattoria Nicolucci and the Vigna del Generale, especially. It is a real star in the... In the
no one secrets.
...of the Romagna wines.
No one secrets in Vigna del Generale, only job and a lot of work behind my shoulder and the shoulder of my father and my grandfather.
Okay.
Predappio Alta is a little town, and I think the particularity of Predappio Alta, I think is the soil, because it's a geologic anomaly, because in Predappio Alto there are calcareous and sulfur soil, and over the miners of this hills, I have my vineyards. So. And I think this is the reason for why
the relation, the relationship between acidity and tannins, is due to the vintage 2017 for you, or it's normal to have this kind of balance between the two parts of the wine, because there is a good acidity and a fantastic. Contains of polyphenols, no, in this wine.
Yeah. Also, in the hot summer and the hot vintage, we have good acidity.
Mm.
And
but in 2017, it was a so hot vintage.
Yeah.
The acidity is not so normal in some 2017 for this reason.
Yes. No? Maybe is it depends for the hire of for my vineyard 350 and 400 on sea level.
Yes, of course. But Predappio is a particular part of Romagna.
Yeah. For a geological soil is very very different.
Yes.
Predappio Alta between Predappio is completely different. Two kilometers of distance and change completely the soil.
So the idea to divide the Romagna in different sub areas is a good idea in your opinion, because all the areas are different characters. And like in all the most important wine area of the world.
Yeah.
So if you go to Barolo, the Serra Lunga is different from La Morra.
No? Yes.
Or Treso is different from Barbaresco in the area of Barbaresco. So in Romagna is the same for the facing of the Sangiovese in different expressions. No? So it's difficult to explain this, because Romagna is not so famous as Barolo or Burgundy, of course. But this happens, and this is very important, because the Sangiovese has really different expressions, and the territory is rich and very interesting, because it's a hilly territory.
Yes, a lot of faces, a lot of...
Yes. So yes. This is very important. And the maceration, it's 20 days of maceration during...
Yes, 20 days in a cement tank. We use only cement tank. And after refining around 2 years in a big cask oak.
Yes.
Spurred cordon, short pruning, around 2 kilo of plant per plant of
so the concentration is due also to that because
yes.
Thank you, Alessandro.
Compliment. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Fine, of course. Okay. If you have some questions, if you want to, you are feel you free to make the questions about wines, about what you want. But if not, I have to go on, of course. And have probably a little problem. I don't know very well because my wife is not here to explain me what happens and explain what happens because I don't know well what happens with the next producer.
No, she's fine. She got online. Okay, she got here.
Fantastic.
We apologize for this delay. We sought to give a little bit more time to someone who needed it.
We had before an Albana from Bertinoro. Now we have a Sangiovese from Bertinoro and is a Sangiovese Superiore Riserva Bissoni and it is the vintage is a 2016. Is a 2016. Yes, ecco. Is a 2016, of course, and it's a bio organic wine. It's a sample number six, and is a very little estate Bissoni, 5 hectares only, and 30,000 bottles only. There is an aging in French oak barrels for 18 months of this wine, and the color is a very garnet color. The nose is spicy, fruity, with some a little aromatic oak in the nose. It's a fantastic balance between tannins and acidity. It's a 2016, but it's still young, this wine, and it's very, very interesting. And we have with us Raffaella Bissoni, an organic producer of Romagna Sangiovese in Bertinoro. And I want to ask her if she want to comment and to introduce the estate and of herself, of course. Raffaella Bissoni, please.
Can you see me? Because
yes, no, I don't see you. Oh. But I hear you.
I try to. I have some.
Okay, now I see you.
I was trying to check with my computer. Okay. Well, yes, it is. I have 12 hectares of property and only 5, but I am hectares of vineyards. I am planting now another hectare and mainly Sangiovese and some Albana. Here everything is organic and I have a very natural approach living on in the vineyard only wild plants. For this reason, after so many years of this system, there are quite a lot of plants, wild plants with give a balsamic taste to the wine.
Spicy and balsamic, really.
Yes.
The spicy, the cinnamon in the nose, the aromatic wood, and together with some red fruits that are very, very evident. It's a very artisanal wine, but really well done.
Yeah, this wine age in a new barrel, but this kind of barrel are totally toasted. So with the wine has a contact only with toasted wood, not plain wood, and only French barrique. This wine, this vintage was a very nice vintage, but we do always a small quantity of production, only 55 tons per hectare. And we leave the wine in tank for the fermentation, and then goes in barrique for 18 months.
I want to say that 2016 is a fantastic vintage for all Italy and for Magna too, of course, no? 2016.
Well, what I have to answer is that, of course, 16 is a very, very good vintage. But yeah, when you work well with low production and take care of the vineyard so much and you have very good grapes, usually all vintages are very nice, also if someone are more pleasant, of course. But I must say that they are all nice.
But you are an artisanal winery, an artisanal estate, and so the attention you pay to the production is incredible. And the organic choice and the so-called natural choice, it's very important to make very individual wine that is possible to distinguish with the others. And so the character are the real evident and very nice in this wine. Also artisanal, it's also authentic.
Yeah, also the soil, the kind of soil is quite important. We are in a place where there are many fossils, also a little bit sandy soil. And for this reason, the grapes are so perfumed, and the wine too.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you to all of you.
Yes. The seventh sample is from Bertinoro too, and the name of the wine is Romagna Sangiovese Riserva Bertinoro Petra Onori, P. Dot, Onori, that is the Stone of Honor, and was the ancient name of Bertinoro, of the place, of the town of Bertinoro, during the Gothic War. And we are talking about the 6th century after Christ, the 6th century. The Greek Gothic War in Italy was fought a lot of centuries ago. And the producer of this wine, the Petra Onori, is Tenuta La Viola, and Tenuta La Viola in Bertinoro, and Tenuta La Viola is owned by the Gabellini family. We are not in altitude, we are not more than 100 meters on the sea level, but in a particular area. 1 year of aging between Tonneau and Big Barrel. And 2016 too, the color is a little lighter than the previous, probably, but not so much lighter. The nose is spicy and fruity and very varietal, because the ripe Sangiovese, it's evident in this wine. And in this case, too, the relationships between tannins and acidity is a good relation. Probably the tannins are a little more evident than in some previous wines. But this is the character of this part of area. And we are in Bertinoro. If you come back to the map of Sangiovese, we can see where Bertinoro is, because it's important to show where is Bertinoro. And where is Bertinoro? It's between Forlì and Cesena. So in the middle between Forlì and Cesena. And this is the part of Bertinoro. So in Bertinoro there is a great tradition of winemaking, of course, because in Bertinoro there are some fantastic producer of Albana, but also fantastic producer of San Normagna, Sangiovese too. This is an organic estate since 1999. So it's one of the pioneers of the organic wine making in Romagna. And the Gabellini family is the owner of this estate, and probably there is Stefano Gabellini with us that can tell us about this estate and the wines.
Daniele, hi everybody.
Hi.
Nice to meet all of you.
So
you can see the pictures behind me. It is Bertinoro. Bertinoro is the first hill after the flat land that came from the sea. My estate, the most of the main estate look at the sea. So the first thing that I see in the morning is the sun that rises from the sea, and is very nice pictures.
Bertinoro, clay and chalk in Bertinoro.
Correct. The main characteristic is this type of soil that allow the wine to be rich in tannin, like as we tasted, but these tannin are very smooth and soft. Well integrated, soft, well integrated with the wine. You don't need to wait too much before to be able to drink and enjoy the wine from Bertinoro. And the wine from this area are rich also of sapidity due to the typical soil that we have. And also for me, also because we are not so far from the sea, because there are just 25 kilometers from the sea level. So we have the breeze that send to us the fresh air from the sea, and maybe these together with the soil give sapidity to our wine.
Probably some salt too,
yes, of course.
That reach the grapes, reach the bunches, and gives some sapidity to the wine. But the most important things to understand that the more you go in altitude, the more acidity you find in the wine. The more you go toward the sea, the more sapidity you have in the wine. So this is the great character, and the more tannins too you have in the wine, probably. So it's like the relationships between, I don't know, the Chianti Classico and Brunello di Montalcino. The Brunello is close to the sea, closer to the sea, and the Chianti Classico is inside Tuscany. And in Romagna is the same. So if you go toward the sea, you have more tannins and probably less acidity, and the opposite if you go in altitude is the opposite, of course. This is a fantastic wine. It's a biodynamic, this wine.
We started 3 years ago with the biodynamic technique in the vigna.
Okay.
Not a long story, biodynamic, just 3 years.
So you are in conversion, you are changing
we are starting
conventional into biodynamic.
Yes, for the vigna. We wanted to have this new journey, a new experience, because I tasted personally several wine that came from biodynamic vigna, and I liked them, and I want to try what it means to grow my vigna in biodynamic.
You know that in France, La Romanée-Conti and Zindum Brecht, they are biodynamic, so it's not a case. But there are also some bad wine biodynamic, less than in the past, but still, unfortunately.
Is the reason why, even if I certified organic since the 1999, I never put on my label organic. I just started in the last year, because in the past, organic, it was not equivalent to good quality. It was equivalent to, natural, but not so good.
it's a responsibility, not an excuse.
but now the world is changing, and it is possible to find a lot of very good organic wine.
Thank you very much.
Well, thank you.
Very interesting. And we finish with a wine that is not a Sangiovese. It's a Cabernet Sauvignon, 100%, aged in barrel, of course, produced by Drey Donat, that is tenuta La Palazza by Drey Donat. And it's a Cabernet, and it's the first Cabernet produced in Romagna. They produce this wine from 1984, so 36 years that they produce Cabernet Sauvignon, and it's a real now it's traditional. The 1984 was a real revolution, and of course the color is completely different from the Sangiovese. The nose is a nose of black currant, a classic of Cabernet Sauvignon, and blackberries and spicy scents, and the body is completely different. The tannins are more evident, acidity less evident, but this is the character of a Cabernet Sauvignon. So the name is Magnificat, single vineyards. Producer is tenuta La Palazza by Drey Donat, and we have an old friend of mine, Enrico Drey Donat. Hi, Enrico.
Hi, Daniele. Hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody. Let's introduce us, the Tenuta La Palazza and your family, and explain, please, the reason for what you make a Cabernet Sauvignon in Romagna. You don't make only Cabernet Sauvignon, you make also the Notturno, a lot of good Sangiovese, but this is a Cabernet Sauvignon.
Yes, that's our estate is located on the first round hill of the Predappio sub-appellation. And when my father started working and taking care of the vineyards on the States in the late 70s, he was hanging around tasting wine and trying to find a route for the quality, of course, and to route how to show the expression of the terroir of our estates. At the moment, of course, late 70s, beginning of 80s, was just of the beginning of many Cabernet Sauvignon in Italy. So Angelo Gai, at the end of the 70s, started planting the Cabernet Sauvignon from where it came, Darmaggi.
Asti Gaia in 68.
Asti Gaia much, much earlier, of course. But if you imagine, Ornellaia started in 1986. So it was Maestro Raro from Felsina. Many producer was explore the way of the Cabernet Sauvignon in the vineyards. My father was so fascinated that kind of stuff, so that beside of the work on the Sangiovese, decided he wanted to plant a Cabernet Sauvignon. The first big problem that was in 1984, Cabernet Sauvignon was a grape that was not allowed by law to be planted in Romagna. So
if I can add something, in Colli Bolognesi in the 70s, yes, Mr. Vallania make one of the first vineyards of Cabernet Sauvignon in Italy, so in the 70s.
Exactly. But and not at all. But you know, in Emilia was still allowed. In Romagna, by the law at that time, was not allowed. Of course, I always joke, so I want to tell my father, if it's not allowed, he want to do it. And so he started planting these vineyards with the support of the University of Bologna as an experimental vineyards, and he planted these 2 hectares of Cabernet Sauvignon. All the vines came from French, from Bordeaux, and he started the first vintages in the bottle was just released under red table wine, because it cannot be named as a Cabernet Sauvignon. We start naming it as a Cabernet Sauvignon with the 1992 vintage, because in 1992 it was a change of the law, and Cabernet Sauvignon, I'd like to say also, after my father experimental, was allowed to be planted in Romagna. And so in 1992 it became Cabernet Sauvignon from Forlì.
was not very lucky because 84 was a terrible vintage. Oh, 92 the same. So
32 again, the same. I was born in 1973. There was another awful vintage. So there is a sort of connection of awful vintage in my wine history.
You know, the first experimental Ornellaia was 84. I tasted the Ornellaia 84 with Giacomo Takis a lot of years ago. Was the first experimental vintage. They didn't put in the bottles because it was awful. But the 84 was you started in the same year with Ornellaia, because 84 was the first year with Ornellaia. So.
No, it's a nice story. I think that the Cabernet Sauvignon expressed very well the potential of our terroir, and is always a wine we and a vineyards we maintain and continue vinifying in very classical ways. All today, all the vineyards are run under organically agriculture. We are certified organic, and moving working through in biodynamic practice and tasting biodynamic practice in the States. And so that they are continuing working, try to improve as much as possible the quality and environment in our terroir. I think it's a wine that from Romagna, it represents a turning point, you know, because technically it was the really first wine that really shows our terroir in the international competition very well in the early 90s. At that time, of course, it was much more interesting in tasting Chardonnay, Cabernet Sauvignon. Was an easy way even to compete worldwide. And just give you a meter of judgment, easy to understand to everybody. So Cabernet Sauvignon was very well known. If you produce a great Cabernet Sauvignon, it really shows the potential of the terroir you work with. And that really helped us a lot also to introduce us all our production. The main production is Sangiovese, of course, because we never forget from where we came from and how much is important Sangiovese for our terroir. But really, this wine helps us to show our states, show our terroir, and help us also to introduce Sangiovese. And it's a little piece of history from Romagna.
About winemaking, is 20 months in French oak barrel.
Yes, there is an average of 20 months of French oak barrel, very classic barrique. We usually work with Vicard, Taranso, or François Frère. Okay. Almost 40-45% of new oak and the rest of a second passage oak. It's a wine that really needs a longer refinement. Just to give you an idea, we are about when we, in harvesting point, when you pick up the grapes, the phenolic concentration is 5,500. That's quite high and strong. We don't make any filtration. So it's a wine that in the beginning, this is a 2016, at the beginning of his life, tend to be very masculine, very full body. It works very well. So if you taste 92 now, that's not a great vintage. It's still very, very nice to drink. 93, that was very opulent, is still very young and funny to drink in this moment. So you have a really long, long aging potential in the bottle.
This 2016 is still young, of course.
Yeah.
It takes, I think, 10 years to have a real balance. You can start to drink now, but if you wait for some years, it's better, of course, no? Because the tannins are very opulent in this wine, that the body is very opulent. I don't know the alcohol content.
It's 14.7.
More than 14 and
14.7 exactly. It's marked 14.5 on the labels, but it's 14.7.
And pH is 3.8, probably
3.9.
So it's a Mediterranean Cabernet Sauvignon.
Absolutely, yes, absolutely.
It's closer to a California, it's a Napa Valley Cabernet than a Bordeaux.
It's opulent. It's could be. It's very good. I like personally to drink when it's a little bit more aged in a bottle, because it's much more refined, much more complete.
Mm-hmm. Okay, the current vintage is available is one of the questions.
Current vintage is 2016, and we're going to release 2017 across this summer.
Back 2017 means very a lot of aging, of course, because it will be solid wine, not, no, because 2017 is a big and hot vintage. So
exactly.
If you have 5.5 of polyphenols in 2016, you have no, six and something.
It's quite massive. In 2017, it's really massive.
It's a solid wine, a solid rock, like a solid rock, you know. Okay, thank you very much, Enrico.
Thank you, everybody.
It was a real pleasure to see you. We are at the end of this tasting. I don't know if you have some questions, because we are still here, everybody. And so is the right moment to make questions if you want. If not, I, of course, thank you for your attention. I leave the last words to my wife that speaks English much better than me, and apologize, of course, for my broken English. But so, Marina.
Okay. Any questions coming from some of you? Can we help you in some way? Our American friends? Well, I can see there are no questions. Then, Daniele, you have been speaking very well.
Oh, thank you very much.
So it's you succeeded. True, but... Thank you to everyone for being with us. And you will receive the registration of the whole event and with the recording, okay? And I will ask you again, if you don't mind, you're going to be on our YouTube channel of Dr. Wine with this recording. But I will certainly write to all of you to just have everything set up properly. So thank you everyone, and we hope to see you soon. Grazie a tutti, grazie per i vostri interventi e per aver spiegato bene tutti i vini.
Okay.
Ciao, thank you.
Bye bye.
See you in Romagna. See you in Romagna. We wait for you.
Okay.
Ciao.
Bye, everybody. Thank you.